Of the 400 local authorities in England and Wales, Tower Hamlets ranks first for overcrowding, second for unemployment in Greater London, and third for multiple deprivation. It's an area of stark contrast, with acute deprivation on one side and luxury housing in docklands on the other. The task facing Tower Hamlets is to reconcile the two extremes, encouraging private development whilst breathing life into areas which can't be revived by private means. To achieve this, the council needs £120 million funding under the Housing Investment Programme, which includes £5.4 million to finance new build schemes, providing accommodation particularly for the homeless, £102 million for renovating and improving council estates, £2.84 million for improvements to private sector housing to continue in housing action areas, and £6.7 million to finance new schemes by housing associations and co-ops, providing large family houses in areas such as Bethnal Green and the Isle of Dogs. The council has responsibility for the housing and environmental welfare of its residents on a scale unequalled anywhere in London. Out of the 67,000 homes in Tower Hamlets, 8% is owned by housing associations. 19% is privately owned or rented, and 73% is owned by the council. Galleon House on the Isle of Dogs is typical of the council's housing stock. Built in the 60s on a large estate, it's now in need of major repair.
I've been living here for 2 years now. We have a very severe damp problem here. We have a drain pipe which comes down and everything is a lot worse in winter. This goes all the way down. We have very severe problems with painting and decorating. Everything's coming off. This wall is just a piece of wood or asbestos as far as we know, and a pane of glass on the outside. Down here, the skirting is, the floorboards are coming away from the skirting. That's just absolutely hollow and you can see daylight through it. Incredible drafts. And here, obviously it's a lot better.
Some of the worst examples of poor housing in London can be seen in the private sector and Tower Hamlets, with overcrowding, lack of amenities and structural problems common in areas like Spitalfields and Shadwell. But the Parfett Street housing action area in Stepney shows that we can dramatically reverse this deterioration given the resources. 62 crumbling terraced houses like these have been transformed by a 1.1 million enveloping scheme which repaired the decaying exterior of each house. This is only the second time a London council has used this method to carry out improvements. The alternative would have been demolition, moving over 90 Bangladeshi families away from their community. Unless the resources are found, we will be forced to abandon similar schemes in other areas and demand demolition on a scale not seen for 20 years. Over 1,000 homeless families in Tower Hamlets are forced to live in temporary accommodation, many in hotels, with overcrowding putting unbearable pressures on family life. And the figure is increasing by over 100 each month. We now spend more than any other London borough on bed and breakfast accommodation. £18 million this year, 1/7 of our total budget. Millions of pounds wasted, because the council is prevented from spending this money on building or renovating homes for rent. Yet the government's own estimates show that it costs only £7,000 to build a council house in the first year, compared with £11,000 for a hotel room. On that basis, Tower Hamlets could build 2,000 new homes. In a bid to reduce the number of homeless families in temporary accommodation, Tower Hamlets has entered into schemes with private developers to renovate some of the 3,000 empty properties in need of major repair. Neighbourhood void panels have also been introduced to speed up lettings, with more use being made of private licensed accommodation for housing the homeless. Tenants at present under occupying large properties are also being encouraged to move to smaller accommodation, releasing these properties for the homeless. But the demand for large four-bedroom accommodation still outweighs the supply. A family requiring this type of accommodation would usually have to wait over 3 years. Accommodation suitable for the elderly, disabled and single is also in short supply. With over 23,000 elderly people living in the borough, the demand for warden-assisted and sheltered accommodation is increasing. Housing association schemes such as Ruth Court in Bow provide the type of flats needed by the elderly, but require extra funding if they are to continue. Over 80% of the housing stock is made up of flats, with more people living above the fourth floor in Tower Hamlets than anywhere else in the country. As a result, there is a drastic shortage of low-rise accommodation adapted for people with disabilities. Single people are also affected, with the shortage of bedsits and one-bedroom accommodation forcing them to either leave the borough, breaking family ties, or live in large impersonal hostels. Over the last 5 years, more than 2,000 new homes have been built in Tower Hamlets by housing associations and cooperatives, providing the type of accommodation needed most by the elderly, disabled and single. But more than £6 million will be needed over the next year just to fund ex-GLC schemes. Without this continued financial support from the council, housing associations will be forced to rely solely on Housing Corporation funding. This would lead to a considerable reduction in the number of new homes for rent at a time when homelessness is spiralling. Unless this basic need for accommodation is met, the homeless situation cannot and will not improve. The council's housing strategy is aimed at tackling homelessness, encouraging the choice of tenure, decentralising the housing service, and maximising investment in the public sector. In addition to the measures already mentioned, the council plans to provide more family-sized homes through new build or renovation schemes. St John's Estate on the Isle of Dogs is one site where a development is proposed. £11.8 million would enable completion of all the planned schemes and rehouse 180 families. Private developers are encouraged to become involved in new build and renovation schemes. Montieff Estate in Bow is just one example. The joint scheme by the council and Assured Developments Limited will mean the total refurbishment of all 390 high-rise homes and demolition of all but one of the low-rise blocks, making way for homes with gardens for rent, sale or shared ownership. Estate-based housing offices, each with their own repair teams, have been set up throughout the borough, providing a more effective housing service, responding more quickly to local problems. Central heating, lifts, entry phones and TV aerials will be installed in over 24,000 homes over the next 5 years as part of the council's £120 million advanced leasing program. The government has expressed concern over the plight of the inner cities and the homeless. Nowhere is this more relevant than Tower Hamlets, and this should be reflected in the allocation of funding under the Housing Investment Programme. £120 million will enable Tower Hamlets to continue with schemes to improve substandard housing and bring empty properties back into use to rehouse the homeless. Without it, thousands of families will be condemned to live in some of the worst conditions in the country. This council has proved that given the resources, it can stop the decay. Now it's your turn.